Hello, welcome to SS Unit Social Design, and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss two more interview questions, and these questions were asked in Optum. So here, as we can see, we have input table and it would have three columns. First is column 1, then column 2, then column 3. And in output, we just want to get only column 1 and column 2. So as we can see the first row, so it is coming from column 1 and column 2. Then in the second row, it is coming from column 1 and column 3. So here the result set will be combined as column 1, then column 2, then column 1, column 3, then column 1, column 2, column 1, column 3. So how we can write the query for getting this output? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will write the query for getting this output. So as I am using SQL 2017, you may have another versions of SQL Server, but this query will work for all the versions. So first of all, I would like to execute the create table script to create the table. So here command completed successfully. So table is created successfully. Now I just wanna insert record on this table, so we can execute this insert statement. So as you can see, 5 rows affected. So data is loaded successfully into the table. Then I just wanna execute the select statement to check the records. So here, as we can see, we are getting the column 1, column 2 and column 3. But in the output, as we seen, first we want column 1, column 2, then column 1, then column 3, like this. So here we can use the column 1, then column 2, and we can use the union all operator, and then we can use select this time column 1 and column 3, and this is from column values table. Now let me execute the query to check the output. So as we can see, we are getting the output like column 1 and column 2, then column 1 and column 3, but this is not in the sequence. So for that, we can use order by clause, and this should be on column 1. Now let me execute the query and we can check the output. So as we can see, we are getting 1, 2, then 1, 3, then 100, 300, 100, 200. So this is the output currently we are getting. Let's move to next question. So in the second question, as we can see, we have input table that would have only one column, and it has 1, 1, 1, 3 times, then 2, 2, 2 times, then 3, then 4, 2 times. But we want only distinct record from this input table. So here we want a distinct record without using distinct operator and CTE with row number. So we don't want to use these two methods by which we can get the distinct records. So what would be the next method by which we can get the distinct records? So here we have a very simple method by which we can get the output. So go to one SQL Server Management Studio, and here as we can see, we have a table. Let me execute this create table script to create the table. So as we can see, table is created successfully. Then I just want to insert record on this table, so we can execute the insert statement. So as we can see, 8 rows affected. So data have been loaded successfully into the table. Now we can check the data from this table. So as we can see, we are getting 1 3 times, 2 2 times, 3 and 4 2 times. But in the output, we want distinct data. So for that, we can use union, and we can copy the above query and paste after the union. Now let me execute this query and we can check the output. So as we can see, we are getting the distinct records without using the distinct operator and CTE with row number. So we can use this for getting the output. So these are the questions which was asked in Optum. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. And if you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video, so you can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching the video.